We found her.
We found her. We found you.
Here she is.
We're back.
Don't worry, Senua.
We'll look after you.
Don't worry,
we'll
Senua.
Make sure you're safe.
She's safe now.
You're always safe with us.
She has us. You've done so well,
you've
Senua.
You've come so far. Listen, Senua.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the
door. No, go in. Don't.
Turn back.
What's it?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me!
Then do it! The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua, it's so loud.
It's not her.
Just so full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
They always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you
see them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
We are your friends.
Anywhere without your light. Take the torch and move. She's lighting the torch.
She's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the torch. I got you saved.
Darkness.
Do you think you can keep away from the sharks?
Have you liked her? The darkness. You're wrong.
These pointless rules. Time. Symbols are pointless. They're meaningless.
Your mother's here.
What have you collected? There's nothing behind the door.
Save Dillian.
The door is just another trick.
Just another trick. Just to distract her from her real mission.
You think you know, but you don't.
Your mother is dead. You don't know anything.
Or is she?
And Dillian is dead.
No, it's not.
It's gonna run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
We can burn out.
She's too slow.
It's not going to do it.
The darkness will come again.
She realized that only she could see them. Her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Get it.
Fire!
She has to go towards it.
She needs to go through the darkness.
The light.
make it through the darkness
Bring
again.
Her. She's too weak.
She will. She has to make it.
Searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only five. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey.
going. Save the light.
Keep going. Where is she going? The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there. He's always
watching you.
She lost it and she has to find it.
I can feel it.
Where is it?
Find it.
Keep the torch alight.
Can you see? Where is she? Where is she?
Your eyes are up.
You're never going to find it.
Okay, I'm going.
Yes.
was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right.
Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's all her fault.
All her fault.
So weak. She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn?
When will she learn? She doesn't understand.
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
The beast has the head and is using it.
Once she gets down there, she'll never come out.
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She was safe. Wasn't that? What's she thinking? She's going to get there.
Thank you.
follow you.
Quick. Stop.
Keep going.
Quick. Stop.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Keep the torch up. Come back to me. Come back.
Do you hear me? I hear you.
Come back to me, Senna.
I'm coming for you.
Follow my voice.
I'm coming.
Come back.
Just keep close your eyes.
Dillian, I see you.
The beast has Dillian.
No! You're not taking it from me!
I've warned you, Senua. I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your gods.
I am leaving with him!
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell. Come into my shadow.
Dillian.
Then listen.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection.
But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel.
He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived.
Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shut up. Listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountains, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.